The first Georgians reigned during the Age of the Enlightenment, a time of new ideas in philosophy, science, and politics. The central tenet of the Enlightenment was a belief in liberty and a refusal to accept any authority without question. Most continental monarchs were threatened by these developments. So why were things so different here in Britain? Why did the British royal family give so clear an endorsement to the ideals of the Enlightenment? Much of this has to do with Queen Caroline, wife of George II. She was seen as the social and intellectual face of monarchy, admired by those in power and popular amongst the people. Aristocratic women did receive an education at this time, but it tended to be quite narrow. Queen Caroline, on the other hand, had had a broad education and retained broad intellectual interests throughout her life, above all in history and natural sciences. But she had another advantage. Before she'd come to England, she had come in contact with one of the great minds of the early Enlightenment, the philosopher and mathematician Gottfried Wilhelm Leibniz. Throughout her life, Caroline corresponded with some of the period's greatest thinkers. In return, they acknowledged her in their work. Their number included Mark Catesby, who dedicated to her the first volume of his lavish publication on American birds. Caroline was open-minded and courageous. She showed a lead in having her own children inoculated, running the risk that they might die of smallpox. She also used items in the royal collection to educate herself and her children. Catherine, tell me about the jewellery here.
Well, these are not actually wearing jewels. These were collected by Queen Caroline and kept in her most private closet at Kensington Palace. And you can see there's a good selection here of different historical characters. So these were people that Caroline was particularly interested in.
So what is the most significant example out of this group here?
Well, I think this one of Elizabeth I was considered the highlight of Caroline's collection.
A new queen arriving in England, that's a very powerful role model.
Exactly. I mean, Elizabeth, as we know, was a very educated woman, interested in many ideas, Shakespeare's queen. And the Tudor period, I think, was of particular fascination to Caroline. So she was a great role model. And in fact, she was compared with Elizabeth I by a number of people. And all these cameos, I think, demonstrate Caroline's particular interest in genealogy. She built up at Kensington lines of kings in various different forms.
But also, is there an element of, it's almost like natural history, you're studying the different stones?
In a way, it's a forerunner of a museum. So it was a way of bringing the world to you. And of course, Caroline, particularly interested in educating her children in the ideas of the wider world. So it was like a library, but looking at objects instead of books.
Such was her reputation that Voltaire called her a philosopher on the throne. Queen Caroline formed magnificent painting displays of her own and was mocked by George II for barging into people's houses to see their painting collections. But both these things were aspects of the way in which she engaged in the intellectual life of her adopted country. And in this way, she gained the respect and the admiration, especially of the metropolitan elites. The hanging plans of her picture closet at Kensington Palace were published soon after her death.
What you're seeing here is one of the walls of Queen Caroline's closet at Kensington Palace with the art display that she formed there.
What is it made up of?
All sorts of things, paintings, drawings, prints, a lot of works of Hans Holbein, of whom she seems to have been particularly fond.
And these came from the royal collection, which she's brought out and redisplayed, as it were.
The Holbein drawings were in a book when she came across them. They were stored at Kensington and she took them out of the book, she framed them, she had them hung on the wall of her closet.
But it's difficult to think of anybody who so kind of intellectually has rifled through the royal collection and rethought it from scratch.
She shows a real spark of interest in the works themselves. The fact that they are clearly labelled with the sitters' names, and we know that at the time she had them taken out of the album, she had the names inscribed on the drawings, so she's interested in the individuals.
Is Queen Caroline trying to say something about herself with this arrangement?
Well, this is an art collection which was owned by her ancestors as kings and queens, her predecessors rather than her ancestors.
Yes.
But this is the Tudor court. On other walls there are pictures of other of the Tudor monarchs. So within the court of the 18th century, she's showing the court of the 16th century.
So is there a slight message of I, coming from Germany, understand this history of my adopted country.
Absolutely. She has the names written on the drawings almost as a reference for who the sitters are. She's interested in the characters as well as the art.
Caroline was reminding the people that Britain had a tradition of strong women like Elizabeth I, educated and capable of running the country in the absence of a man. And she herself ran the country as regent when George II was in Hanover. Altogether, it's not surprising that people sang this song. You may strut, dapper George, but 'twill all be in vain. We all know 'tis Queen Caroline, not you, that reigns.